The next numbering system we're going to talk about is called the octal numbering system. An octal is base 10. And what are the possible digits in octal? Okay? You ready to count an octal? Can you see? Okay, so to count an octal, it's going to start off with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then what's going to happen after 7? Well, we typically call it 1, 0. And why did I go from 1, 0 after 7? Because I'm out of digits, so I have to go over to the next placeholder. Okay? So it's going to go 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. What happens after 1, 7? 2, 0. 2, 0. Okay. Now, the advantage of octal. Okay, well, first of all, before we talk about the advantage, let's talk about the disadvantages of binary. Can anybody tell me what you think some of the disadvantages of binary are? It takes up a friggin' lot of space, right? I mean, imagine we just did some small numbers. Imagine if you have a huge number. Could you try to write that down? Wouldn't you lose digits and all that type of thing? So it's a very inconvenient method to write in. Okay, but I forget, why are we using binary? The machine uses binary. Why does the machine use binary? Because it's faster, right? Why does the machine use binary? It's electronic. It's the only two states it can represent, on and off. Like when you're a desert island, you have flashlights, on or off. Those are the only way you can signal. Okay? 0 and 1, on or off. The only two signals. Okay. Now, octal is used because it's a more convenient way to represent binary. So a lot of programmers use octal rather than writing the long binary values. It's a little more convenient to represent binary this way. And hopefully you'll get used to automatically doing some of the conversions. Okay, so here's how we convert from, which one did I do first? From binary to octal. Okay? Here's how we convert, and I'll put the same number up and I'll do it. Let's see. One, zero, 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 one, 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 zero. Okay, so you get this long binary number, and the first thing you do is you start at the right, and you group three digits. So I group these three, and these three. And then I look up the three digits that I've identified, and I find the corresponding octal value. This is binary. So I'm going to look up 110 in binary, and what is the corresponding octal value for that? 6. So I put a 6 right under here. Then I get to the next guy, and the good news about this guy is I might not need to look at the chart. Because what do I know about 001? It's 1. It's 1 in any other numbering system. So I don't really have to look it up. I kind of know that by heart. Okay? What about 1? Now, do you see that leading zeros don't matter? Just like in decimal. Okay? So now 100, I happen to know is a 4, but you can look it up in the chart here, and you're then going to put this digit right here and have the corresponding octal value for the binary number. So no math is required for binary to octal. It's just a lookup. And you're going to find you're going to start to remember these numbers. Okay, so let's try one. Let me give you one. Okay, so I gave you a long one, but that's okay. So it's 4 1s, 3 0s, 1 3 0s, and a 1. So go ahead and write this down, and then convert this to an octal value. 4 1s, 3 0s, 1 3 0s, and a 1. And what should the rule be when you convert this? What's your steps? Start from the right. Start from the right. Start from the right. The first one should be kind of easy. Yeah? For octal, it's always 3. We're going to do hex in a minute, and that's going to be by 4. But by 3s this time. Good. Okay, so look at your chart if you're not sure about this one. So look up, now, so 1 0, because leading zeros don't matter. So what's 1 0 on the chart? Look in the binary. We had one, which was this guy, 1. But 1 0 is down, and see the 1 0 in the binary guy? And that's a 2. Does that make sense? A 0 doesn't make any difference. Don't let the 0 throw you off. So 0 1 0 is a 2. And then what's 1 0 0? Right. So you get the, okay? Okay, so did you group 3s? So you group 3. You group 3. 3. So put a little gooey here. There's the first guy. Now you group the next 3. So what's 0 1 0? What's 1 0? Look at your chart. Group them by 3s. Then look up each value. So don't let the leading zeros throw you off. It's 1 0. So what's 1 0 in binary? What is that equivalent to in octal? 2. You getting it? Okay, there is no 8. Oh, that's just the base. Okay. That just says this is an octal number. Okay. Because otherwise I would think of decimal. How are we doing with this? Everybody doing okay with this? Okay, good. Okay, is this making sense? Okay, good. Good. Okay, good. Good. Okay. So now let's do one more because I want you to see something. Let me do another one. Okay, so go ahead and do another one. I want you to see something along the way. So this one has 3 1s, 3 0s, 3 1s, and 0 0 1. So do one more. Question, you know? Okay, that just says that it's a base 8 number. I mean, because, yeah. Those are both 7. Yeah, I picked an easy number on purpose. So you start to see that you know these numbers automatically, and you don't have to really look them up. Okay. Now, why was that easy? Easier. Zero is easy. What else was easy? 1 and 7 are easy. I always remember 7 is 1, 1, 1. So you start to remember these, and it's really not a lookup. Do you see what I'm saying? So you always know that a 1, 1, 1 is a 7. You always know a 0, 0, 0 is a 0. You always know 0, 0, 1 is a 1. If you know a 7 is 1, 1, 1, what can you guess about 6? 1, 1, 0. So you start to get a feel, and it's really not looking it up. Most of these we know by heart. Okay? Especially if you do this frequently. Now, let's do the reverse. Let's go from binary to octal. So in this case, I have an octal number, 53. So I look up the 3, but I must fill in all 3 digits. can't drop leading zeros, right? I've got to keep the leading zero if there is one. So 3 then is what? 1. So I have to do 0, 1, 1. Does everybody see that? Three is 1, 1. But the rule is you have to fill in all 3 digits. Okay? So 5 is what? 1, 0, 1. And you're done. So that's the binary from hex to binary. Okay? Did I say hex to binary? Yeah, we haven't done hex yet. Octal to binary. All right, let me give you one at your seats. Okay, so go ahead and give me the binary for 731 octal. Start at the right. Start at the right. So start at the right. So 1 is what? Put below that what the binary of 1 is. 1, but put 2 zeros. Got to have 3 digits. Okay, good. 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 Okay. 1 is 0, 0, 1. So now what's 3? Correct. And 7 you probably even know before you even look it up. Right. Mm-hmm. That's it. So it's 001, 011, 111. See? Told you you were going to like this.